being in a forestry company, the only way we're going to be able to sustain ourselves is to replant trees. We're on a planting site that we are bedding, and we're planting it with machines, wheel tractors, planting loblollies, and we're planting on about 5 feet apart in the bed. Here in the Southeast, we have a land classification system which is based on soils, the type of soils and the drainage of those soils. On a lot of the area here in the Satilla Forest, it's lower, more poorly drained soils, so we'll bed those. Almost all of our trees are grown in our own nursery in the Alberta nursery. At the nursery, they'll lift these trees and put them in bags, and they'll load them on a refrigerated van, and planters will get the bags as needed on a daily basis.
All the trees here in the Pacific Northwest are planted by hand. A planting crew member is going down all these steep slopes, sticking a shovel in the ground and putting each tree into the ground one by one. The ground is a bit too rugged. There are obstacles, there are old stumps, there's a lot of water around. So we can't bring machinery around to plant the seedlings like they might do in the Southeast United States. We plant primarily in the winter and early spring. That's when the tree seedlings are shut down. The conditions here in Western Washington in the winter are ideal for planting. It's cold and rainy, which is perfect conditions to be planted in.
We'll grow these trees to 25 years. The average age in this area is about 21 years. As they grow, we may thin these trees, which means we'll just take out some of the trees and send them to the market, and the other trees will stay and have a chance to get a little bigger than they would if all the trees were on the same acre.
We've got a nice clear stem. The leader is straight, and there's no forks and there's no bends. The roots are nice and spread out, and we've got not only these coarse roots, coarse lateral roots, but the fine root tips that are growing, and they're going to be able to access the water and the nutrients in the soil around them. This tree also has a really nice caliper, so the stem is thick. It was growing vigorously at the nursery, so that first year when it's in the field, it's going to be using all that energy that it had at the nursery. The slash on the ground around it is going to provide cover from the sun when it starts beating directly down onto the soil. Also, all this bark around is more of that compost and kind of slow release fertilizer that's going to be used throughout the seedling's life.
I know that some people are not sure that in this industry that we're actually planting trees. They see a lot of cutting, but they don't always see the planting. So yes, we do plant trees, and we do that every year. I plant approximately about 4,000 acres a year.
The trees are 2 years old when they are planted, but we're gonna call them year zero right now, and so they'll grow another 40 years after that. And then they'll look a lot like the forest that you see behind me.
I've been with Rayonier about 35 years and been involved with the planting part of this for about 30 years. So we start out with seedlings, and in about 20 to 25 years, we've got full-grown trees that we harvest. I've been able to witness that on a lot of acres. These trees will be used for my children and my grandchildren and their children. I've planted those and harvested those and replanted those same sites. So it's good to be able to be in a sustainable industry like this.